It is now the 43rd anniversary of what was the costliest volcanic eruption in U.S. history, the May 18, 1980 eruption of a volcano whose name is now associated with a high degree of destruction, Mount Saint Helens. In mere minutes, this eruption on that deadly day completely scorched an area of more than 230 square miles, causing all trees and vegetation to fall in a single direction facing outwards from the blast, almost like a nuclear explosion had occurred. Thus, I present the sequence of events which led to the costliest volcanic eruption in U.S. history. In the 1970s, Mount St. Helens was known to many locals as the Mount Fuji of the Americas, as it had a highly symmetrical central peak, which towered to a height of 9,677 feet, which, just like Mount Adams to the east, was covered by numerous glaciers. Although recognized as a volcano for more than a century at the time, Mount St. Helens had not produced a volcanic eruption since 1921. However, unknown to everyone at the time, a large body of magma had already begun intruding into the northern flank of Mount St. Helens in the late winter months of 1980. This only led to a definite change to the volcano on March 16th of 1980 as a series of several small magnitude but shallow earthquakes, some of which were large enough to be felt by the local populace, occurred. The rate and magnitude of earthquakes subsequently continued to increase for the next 11 days until suddenly an explosion occurred at the summit of Mount St. Helens, blasting out a 230-foot-wide crater and its dense snowpack. By a week later, repeated explosions that were caused by the interaction of groundwater with shallow magma known as phreatic explosions had widened the crater to 1,300 feet wide. Following this, the number of explosions soon decreased in abundance, going from one an hour to one a day. Then, on April 22nd, the volcano temporarily stopped erupting. But, more ominously, on that date, a section of the northern flank of Mount St. Helens began bulging outwards at a rate of 6.6 feet a day. Eruptive activity resumed on May 7th and continued until May 17th, with the large bulge referred to as a cryptodome caused by an incredibly shallow intrusion of magma having by then pushed a large mass of rock outwards by as much as 459 feet. Then, at 8:32 a.m. the following day, all of the pressure that had built up over a period of several months was released, as the strain of the uplift caused a fault to rupture, generating a magnitude 5.1 earthquake. This quake acted as the final straw, causing 2.5 cubic kilometers of Mount St. Helens to begin sliding all at once to the north as a massive landslide involving three landslide blocks. Within 60 seconds, the volcano lost 1,370 feet in height, and all of the volatile materials and gases in the cryptodome exploded outwards in two directions. One section blasted upwards as a towering 80,000-foot-high eruption column, while the other main component exploded outwards to the north as a lateral blast, which involved a several hundred-foot-high incinerating 800 degrees Fahrenheit gas cloud, which expanded outwards at a speed of 300 miles per hour. While the pyroclastic flows only traveled up to 5 miles distant, superheated gases continued to race outwards farther than this, blasting all trees flat facing away from the blast wave and starting fires, destroying everything in its path, including numerous cars and over 200 structures up to a distance of 19.3 miles away. Within minutes, 600 square kilometers of forest with many structures and nearly 5 dozen people in it were obliterated, causing what was at the time $1.1 billion in damage. As material from the ash cloud drifted to the east, it continued to fall, accumulating in sections of 12 U.S. states as far away as Oklahoma and Minnesota, in addition to large swaths of southern Canada. What had just occurred ejected 1.3 cubic kilometers of volcanic rock, representing the third largest explosive volcanic eruption the modern United States had seen since 1700. On the 0 to 9 volcanic explosivity index, where, with a few smaller exceptions at the lower end of the scale, each increase of one number represents an explosive eruption which is 10 times larger than the 1980 eruption of Mount St. Helens, registered in as a 5. This represented the 8th eruption of this size or larger to occur from Mount St. Helens since the end of the last ice age 11,650 years ago. What was left behind in the aftermath of the 1980 eruption was a large and deep horseshoe-shaped collapse scar whose summit now only reached a height of 8,307 feet. Now, scientists around the world recognize similar-shaped scars at other volcanoes which have undergone nearly identical events in the past, such as Kerem-Khotan in 1933, Bezimiani in 1956, and Mount Meru in 6694 BCE. These other volcanoes show that large collapses and lateral eruptions are not unique to the 1980 eruption of Mount St. Helens. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube, and celebrate publishing a total of more than 1,000 videos.